I'm Denece Bones Parsons. My grandfather came to Little Rock in the very early 1900s. That's when he settled here. My father was actually born in Little Rock. So I am the third generation of the pioneering Bones family, and I currently manage the Bones Ranch and family orchard. My mother was Dorothy Zink, and she actually settled up in the foothills of Little Rock in the 1930s, and they homesteaded there. So both of my parents were pioneers here. I was born in 1960, and I've lived actually on 82nd Street in Little Rock my entire life, having moved out of the area just briefly to teach school and go to college. I attended Alpine School, Antelope School, and Almondale School, and graduated from Palmdale High School before leaving the area to go to college. Okay, I went to Whittier College and started off as a political science major, but changed to biology and got my bachelor's degree in biology and taught school down in the La Habra area. And then I just missed the small town environment of Little Rock, the orchards, and I got a job as an industrial engineer and scheduler on the B1 program for Rockwell and helped my parents with the orchards. And then I ended up getting married, and my husband is now the captain of the fire department here in Little Rock. So when I moved back into town, my father had actually sold off a lot of the acreage of pears and peaches that he had farmed. At one time, the family had farmed well over 100 acres. So I returned, and as my father was in declining health, he needed someone to help out more in the orchard and also at the packing house and fruit stand. So both my husband and I joined my brother, and we helped out my mom as he was in declining health. When he passed away, my mom asked my husband and I to take over the operations, and we've only have a few acres of the original farm left, but we still have many return customers from multi-generations coming for our fruit, so we've decided to continue the venture. Okay, I have so many fond memories growing up in Little Rock. I frequently reminisce about the horseback rides in the foothills, and the community events such as the parades and the hay rides and the barn dances. But my most vivid memories revolve around harvest time in town. And growing up as a child, I would help my father light smudge pots at 3 a.m. and drive tractor. I would learn from 5 years old on up how to pack and sort the pears and peaches and ship them off to market. The customers coming into town would be from all over the world at times, from various generations. And to be able to sell the fresh fruit and share the wonderful stories from Little Rock has just always been a fond memory. We started out on a high-level packing house on Pearblossom Highway, and in 1979 we had to demolish that because of the age of the structure. We built a new one, and we continued to pack pears and peaches out of that, and at that point I started driving forklift. But my favorite part has always been just dealing with customers and interacting with them, because many of them have had grandparents coming here in the mid-1900s, 1920, to buy pears and peaches, and they've continued to come from generation to generation. And to be able to teach my daughters the customer service and how to make change from when they were 5 years old on up has just been a real treasure in our family's history. One of the memories that I have when I was about 4 or 5 was listening to memories of my grandparents and my parents talking about dances that they would have at the corner of 82nd Street and the highway. When it was just a bare field, they would just put up hay bales and have dances outside. And then they started having them in the packing sheds after harvest would be over. They would throw a big party, and actually a lot of the labor workers would throw the party for the orchard owners in celebration of the end of harvest. Later on, those dances ended up going into the Martin Packing House, which at that time Jack Bones Sr. owned, and he would let the Chamber of Commerce put on a barn dance, and that would last till wee hours of the morning, and everyone had a roaring good time. I would really like people to know that Little Rock has a place in history with the development of the dam and agriculture in California, that it definitely has a place for people to go back and remember our roots from California, that it is a community which cherishes its country rural lifestyle, and that it loves its small businesses. And because of bad press, it breaks my heart to see people make the wrong assumption that it is a crime-ridden extension of East Palmdale. Whereas, in fact, to walk the streets, go jogging day or night, to ride your horse in the foothills continues to be an enjoyable, safe pastime. My daughter sometimes will even run the streets at midnight to get in her cross-country training, and we feel completely safe. Well, I'd like more orchards and agriculture to return to Little Rock, and more small businesses to return to town. Decades ago, we had a local pharmacy, a doctor, many cafes, markets, and everyone supported the local businesses. You only went into Palmdale maybe one day a week, either to go to a specialist doctor or to go to a big grocery store. But otherwise, all the rest of the time, we stayed in and supported our local businesses. What I would really like to have stopped would Los Angeles County to stop applying costly and prohibitive urban-style regulations to the businesses and residences in our country town, because it just doesn't apply to the kind of lifestyle that we want to live here in Little Rock. I'd like to see Little Rock always retain its rural and country lifestyle and atmosphere, with no more widening of the highway, no more encroachment by Palmdale, and just for us to be able to enjoy a sense of community once again. One of the things that has changed Little Rock since I grew up has been that instead of it becoming a community where people worked, played, and lived here and supported each other, it's become a more of a bedroom commuter community. And that has changed a lot of the aspects of the town, along with the decline of the Foothill News going away, because we always knew when there was community events, whether it be a fundraising potluck or even just an award ceremony at Almondale or a costume parade at Alpine. It was in the Foothill News and everyone knew about it. The entire community came and supported it. And now that you have the World Wide Web and just people into the whole communications throughout the world, people aren't focused on communicating within their community. And it even goes to businesses supporting one another. The Little Rock Community Church was actually built by the Alpine Grange, the Chamber of Commerce, Alpine school teachers. They all came together on different weekends over several months and built part of that church as a community church. And it's that kind of communication amongst businesses, amongst organizations, that we have truly lost over the past several decades. And it would be really nice to be able to get that back. Little Rock has the best fruit in the world. Not as much anymore, but you still, the apricots, the peaches, the pears, the cherries, even the lilacs here in Little Rock are just absolutely beautiful. And even though we get some of the air pollution from Los Angeles and the gravel pits, we still have wonderful air and wonderful climate here. The thing that surprises me about Little Rock is the number of talented people we have here, from artists to musicians to athletes. It just is so amazing to be talking to people in town or at the local cafe and find out the wonderful talents that people have. As a community, we are very rich in that. Well, by far, it's the country lifestyle, the farming, the family heritage, and a small country church, because all those things just really create a sense of community in a place that I've really wanted to raise my two daughters.